نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم اما بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي صوت القران انجلش وي ار دوينج جوز 24 اند وي ار دوينج شورت سمري ويل ستارت فروم سورة الزمر آية نمبر 32 اند ويل دو اپ تو سورة الفصلت آية نمبر 46 Let's start. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Here we have seen in ayah number 32. So who is more unjust than one who lies about Allah and denies the truth when it has come to him? Is there not in hell a residence for the disbelievers? Means, are they not deserving it? And the one who has brought the truth and they who believe in it, those are the righteous. You know, they believe in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent through the messenger, and that's the reason they will be there. Lahum ma yasha'una inda rabbihim. So those who do believe in Allah. And here we later we see in ayah number 35 that Allah may remove from them the worst of what they did. Means, and he will reward them their due to the best of what they used to do. So there is a hadith regarding that. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that a believer will be brought to his Lord, exalted and glorious on the day of resurrection, and Allah will placed upon his side, and Allah will make him confess his faults and say, do you recognize your faults? And the believers will say, yes, my Lord, I did recognize. Meaning he will admit. Why? Because he was truthful. He lived by the truth in the world. On the day of judgment, when he will be asked about the sins, he will be truthful that time also. So be truthful, Sidq. And here later we see in ayah number 40, to whom will come a torment disgracing him, and whom will descend an enduring punishment. Why? Because they deserve that. They didn't work for the akhirah. Those who work for akhirah, they will get Jannah, because this is the working time. Allah take the souls at the time of their death, and those that do not die, he takes during their sleep. Here in ayah number 42, meaning in sleep, our soul also departs partially. It leaves the body partially. This is why sleep is a sister of death. It's very similar to death, because when a person is dead, does he talk? Does he listen? No, he can't. He eat or drink? No, nothing. So he left this world. So now this is a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed to us daily. You know, he puts to sleep and then we wake up. And then we are not dead, means we wake up and we are fine. But one day, maybe we can die in the sleep. Allah knows. And here, like after waking up, we made dua also. Alhamdulillah, like, you know, Alhamdulillah, Allah has made us alive. Ahyana ba'da ma amatana. What is that? Amatana is from mouth. What kind of mouth? It was like sleep. Sleep is the sister of the death. And then he keeps those of for which he has decreed death and released the others for a specified term. Indeed, in that are signs for the people who give thought. So these are the different signs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing. وَبَدَى لَهُمْ سَيِّئَاتُ مَا كَسَبُوا. And there will appear to them the evil they had earned, and they will be enveloped by what they used to ridicule. You know, whatever they were making fun in this world, and that's the thing they will be having the problem over there. They will have the punishment. And when adversity touches man, you know, kind of adversity, poverty, illness or anything, he calls upon us. When we bestow on him a favor from us, he states, I have only been given it because of my knowledge. You know, when he has problem, he gonna make dua and everything, but when he has given the, you know, anything good, he thinks, you know, he says, oh, because of my knowledge, you know, because I deserve it. You know, you might have noticed many people, you know, I earned this degree because of that, so and so I'm getting it. It's not so. Many people, they did the same course, but they are not getting the same money, isn't it? It's the will of Allah. Allah distribute the provision how he wants. Rather, it's a trial, but most of them do not know. It's a trial from Allah and they do not understand that. And in ayah number 53, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. See, O my servants who have transgressed against themselves. How? Do not despair of the mercy of Allah. Do not despair. لَا تَقْنَتُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Indeed, Allah forgives all sins. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. All the sins. إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Indeed, He is who is forgiving and most merciful. So keep on asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and after repentance, don't go on the same path which you have done the wrong. That's the complete tawbah. And here later we see in ayah number 60, and on the day of resurrection you will see those who lied about Allah with their face blackened. Is they not in hell a residence for the arrogant? Allah is saying, yeah, this is the residence for the arrogant, because they rejected, they lied. And here, after lying, what you expect? وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدَرِهِ. They have not appraised Allah with true appraisal. In ayah number 67, how He has to be appraised. The earth entirely will be within His grasp on the day of resurrection. You know, just imagine in the hand. And the heavens, the skies will fold it in His right hand. Entire thing will be in His right hand. This is in ayah number 67. Exalted is He, high above what they associate with Him. Just imagine the majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then it was said, وَنُفِقَ فِي الصُّورِ, and the horn will be blown, and whoever is in heaven and whoever is on the earth will fall dead except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then it will be blown again, and once they will be standing looking on, you know, like, you know, how they will be startled, you know, they don't know what's going on. And here there's a hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, between the two sounds of trumpets there will be 40. Somebody asked 40 days. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, when he was narrating this hadith, somebody asked him, 40 days. He said, I don't know. The man said 40 months. Abu Huraira said, I don't know. 40 years. Again he refused to reply. Why? Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not specify 40 is how much. So that the trumpet will be blown, every creature will die, everyone. Only his face shall remain, whose? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here later we see in ayah number 73, وَسِيخَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْ رَبَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ جَنَّةِ زُمَرَىٰ. All will be drank in the, you know, but those who fear their Lord will be driven to paradise in groups. They will be taken in the groups. You know, what if, you know, some good people and you followed and you did good and they are with you, and we always want righteous company, isn't it? When they reach it, while its gates have been opened and its keepers say, peace be upon you, salam alaikum, tibtum wadkhulul ha khalidin. Peace be upon you, you have become pure, you were good and you did well, so enter it, abide eternally. So you're gonna be like a permanent resident forever and ever. Like, you know, in overseas, after every 10 years you have to renew your passport, and you know, you have to go to another country, you have to take the visa. But this is khalidina fiha abada, forever and ever. Nobody is, you know, asked to change the place, nobody asking you any paperwork. So, but the thing is, you have to do such kind of things, then only wasiqa allazina taqaw rabbahum ila jannah. So they were taken to the jannah in groups. So make dua and have the righteous company in this world also. You know, a person will be on the deen of his own friend. So if we are thinking like, you know, we are in the bad company and miracle will happen, no, it's not so. If you are good, have that much faith that you affect the other people, not you. Like, you know, it's like a perfume thing. What, like, if you go to the perfume shop, you smell good, but if you go to blacksmith, you have that whole thing on your face and clothes. And on in ayah number 75, and you will see the angels surrounding the throne from all sides, exalting Allah with the praise of their Lord, and it will be judged between them in truth. Means the people of Jannah will be sent to Jannah, and the people of hell will be sent to hell, and it will be said, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praises to the Lord of the world. Because all praises at the beginning and all praises to the conclusion at the ending also. Waqeel Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the first group of people who will enter paradise will be glittering like the moon when it is full. They will not spit, meaning they will not have the need to spit or blow their nose or even use the bathroom. This is the beauty of Jannah. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also, there is one more narration, 70,000 people will enter paradise in one group. And among them there will be people whose faces will be bright like the moon. Who are they? Those who really believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here we learn there's one more thing, like, you know, two kinds of things. You have to give lot of charity and lot of ibadah, that also. And we want to enter all of us in Jannah. Suratul Ghafir. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله عزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول إله إلا هو لا إله إلا هو وإليه مصير. So here Hamim Huruf Muqatta, the revelation of the book is from Allah, the mighty and knowing, the forgiver of sins, acceptor of repentance, severe in punishment, owner of abundance. There is no deity except Him, no God other than. So here our turn is to only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one who forgives us, Allah is clearly saying He forgives us, He accepts our repentance. One who is able to punish severely, Allah is saying clearly, I can punish, but ask me for your sins and forgiveness, Allah will forgive. And here there is no shirk, there is no deity except Allah, and to Him is your return. And here later in the ayah number 10, indeed those who disbelieve will be addressed, the hatred of Allah for you was even greater than your hatred of yourself this day in hell when you were invited to faith but you refused. You know, everybody in this world are invited for hidayah, but they reject. فَدْعُوا اللَّهُ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. We have seen in the previous juz also, you know. So invoke Allah, worship only Him, being sincere to Him in religion, even though the disbelievers dislike it. You know, just فَدْعُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Exclusively ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even though here it's clearly mentioned, even though disbelievers dislike it, but you have to do. This is ayah number 14. And here, the day they come forth, yawmahum barizun, meaning on the day of judgment, people will not be able to hide, they will not be able to run away, fully exposed. Nothing concerning them will be concealed from Allah, to whom belongs all sovereignty this day. Lillahi wahidul qahhar. And later we see in the ayah number 19, ya'lamul khainatal ayun. Allah knows that which deceives the eyes, what the chest conceal. وَمَا تُخْفِ السُّدُورِ. So whatever khiyana you are doing with your ayun, with your eyes, and also know whatever hidden in your chest. And here we see in ayah number 27, وَقَالَ مُوسَى, and Musa al-Islam said, إِنِّي أُسْتُ بِرَبِّي وَرَبِّكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ مُتَكَبِّرٌ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِيَوْمِ الْحِسَابِ. Musa al-Islam said, indeed I have sought refuge in my Lord and your Lord from every arrogant, one who does not believe in the day of account. So here, and after that, فَقَالَ رَجُلٌ مُؤْمِنٌ, and believing man from the family of Pharaoh, who conceal his faith. This is also, you know, we have seen one more in Surah Yasin. Now again here is mentioned. He said, do you kill a man merely because he says, my Lord is Allah? Like, you know, he is asking, because one who believes, you want to kill that, while he brought clear proofs from your Lord. He is asking, you know, if somebody is bringing clear proof, why do you want to kill that person? It's from Bani Israel. If he should be lying, then upon him is the consequence of his lie. He's saying, you know, if he lies, the consequence for him, you know, but if he should be truthful, He's saying, what if he's truthful, then what is going to happen? There will be strike you some of what he promises you. You know, it's going to happen what Allah has promised. Indeed, Allah does not guide one who is transgressor and liar. So this is the another example we have seen, Rajulun Mumin, like how he is conveying the message. And for this, you know, it needs lot of courage and lot of, you know, tawakkul on Allah. Then only you could able to tell this kind of things, you know. Subhanallah, he had both. And have you noticed, name is not mentioned in the Quran, Rajulun Mumin. So we also, you know, try to convey the message how Allah has ordered us. And he who believes said, "Oh my people, indeed I fear for you a fate like the day of companies." This is in ayah number 30. Which companies, which groups? Like the custom of, like, you know, in the we want to be in the people of righteous. We don't want the people which are not righteous, okay? And here in ayah number 35, those who dispute concerning the signs of Allah without any authority coming to them, great hatred of them in the signs of Allah and the sight of those who have believed. Thus Allah does seal over their heart. Because of arrogant and tyrant, their hearts has been sealed. And Pharaoh said to Haman, "Construct for me a tower that I might reach the ways." You know, he's just making fun. Just he's saying, you know, I want to look the rub of the Musa, just make a big lofty tower. And that's the way he's making fun. "Ya Homi, O my people, this worldly life is only temporary enjoyment. Indeed, the hereafter, that is the home of permanent settlement." This is for all the nation, and this is for us too, for the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And here later we see, so Allah protect him from the evils they plotted. Allah saved them. And the people of Pharaoh were enveloped by the worst of punishment. What is the worst punishment? You know, how they were drawn and how Allah saved the Bani Israel and all those things happen. And here later we see in ayah number 52, the day their excuse will not benefit the wrongdoers. You know, people, they make excuse in this world, but that time it won't help. They will have the curse and they will have the worst home. And here we later we see in ayah number 55, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is being consoled, you know, wasbir, so be patient, O sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Inna wa'dallahi haqq, indeed the promise of Allah is truth. And what else has to be done? Wastaghfir li zambika, and ask forgiveness for your sin. وَسَبِّ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ الْوَالْأَشِيلِ وَالْإِبْقَارِ, and exalt Allah with the praise of your Lord in the evening and the morning. And again and again, you know, zikr has been mentioned. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar. And make it a habit to do lot of zikr, inshallah. And this zikr, you know, that will plant the trees in the Jannah. Huwa hal hayyul, he is the ever living, there is no deity except him. So call upon him, being sincere to him in religion. Allah, praise is due to Allah. Again, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen in ayah number 65. See, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, indeed I have been forbidden to worship those who call upon besides Allah. Once the clear proofs have come to me from my Lord, I have been commanded to submit to the Lord of the world, that is Rabbul Alameen. So make dua to only Allah. Then the, you know, how the formation, how the creation of the human being from a sperm drop and then clinging clot, and how the child develops is mentioned in ayah number 67. And Allah mentioned later on how he causes death and how he decrees a matter. But he says, kun fayakun, and it happens in ayah number 68. And later we see in ayah number 79, Allahul ladhi ja'ala lakum an'am, it is Allah who made for you grazing animals upon which you ride and some of them you eat. Isn't it this a rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We are riding and we are using for our, you know, eating also. And here Suratul Fussilat, Suratul Hamim, Sajda, both the names you can call. Hamim, Tanzilul Minar Rahmanir Rahim. Hameem, this is revelation from entirely merciful and specially merciful, a book whose verses have been detailed in Arabic for the people who know. And here later we see, Qul, say, do you indeed disbelieve in He who created the earth in 2 days? And attribute to Him equal, this is the Lord of the worlds. This is in ayah number 9. And later here we see, فَإِنْ أَرَادُوا, if they turn away and they say, I have warned you of the thunderbolt, like the thunderbolt that struck. This is in Aad and Samud, how they were struck with the thunderbolt. Even though they were, you know, warned, they still they don't believe it. And later we see, in ayah number 26, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, and those who disbelieve, deny, do not listen to the Quran and speak noisily. You know, they are لَا تَسْمَعُونَ لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ, you know, they don't listen attentively and speak noisily and, you know, love. And they, during the recitation of the Quran, it helps, you know, they can't overcome. Because, you know, they are making fun of the Quran. So here, many people, they think that, you know, they can listen to the Quran and, you know, it's going on. Listen to it attentively. That's what it means. Otherwise, they will have the torment, you know, in the hellfire. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ, indeed, those who have said, our Lord is Allah, then remain firm on the right course. You know, summa istaqamu, have the istiqama, the angel will descend upon them. Angels come to them, so they see the angels, but the angels become their supporters. You know, you see angels, mean doesn't mean that they are visible, they are invisible, but you feel that, you know, they are supporting you, because Allah is saying that, do not fear and do not grieve, but receive good tidings of Jannah, and which you were promised. So have faith on Allah and, you know, do tawakkul, and Allah will definitely will help you. نَحْنُ أَوْلِيَاءُكُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ, we angels were your aliens in the worldly life and so in the hereafter. You will have therein whatever you your soul desires. You will have there, means what you request, Allah is giving that. Nuzlam min ghafoorur rahim, an accommodation from Lord who is forgiving and merciful. Again, forgiveness, you know, many times forgiveness has been mentioned. So ask forgiveness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنَ قَوْلًا مِمَّا دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَأَمِلَ الصَّالِحًا, and those who is better in speech, you know, they have ahsan speech, one who invites to Allah and does righteous and say, indeed I am of the Muslim. So we all have to do this, inshallah. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he who calls people to righteousness, their reward for him like the one who is doing it. So in this, inshallah, we have to remind ourselves, we should do this, inshallah. This is in ayah number 33. وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا سَيَّا, and not equal are the good and the bad. It is, it's not equal. And when Allah is saying, that's correct, you know, even sometimes Allah says, you know, one who has knowledge, one who don't, and also the one who has the light, one who don't. It's about the hidayah and not having the hidayah. And here we see, nothing is said to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, except what already said to the messengers before you. Meaning, they are criticizing, mocking, don't worry, indeed your Lord is possessor of forgiveness and possessor of painful penalty. Means those people who are not believing, leave them on their own. If we made it a non-Arabic Quran, they would have said, why this verse is not explained in detail in our language? Is it a foreign recitation in Arabic? Means here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, if we made in other language, they will say such thing. But we made in Arabic. And قُلْ هُوَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا هُدَى وَشِفَى, and say, this Quran is hidayat and also shifa and a cure. And later talk about here, about Musa al-Islam. We had already given Moses scripture, but came under disagreement. If not for a word that proceed from your Lord, it would have been concluded between them. And indeed, they are concerning the Quran is decreating doubt. Man amil salihan, but you know, one who do believe, who does righteousness, فَلَنَفْسِهِ It's for his own soul. وَمَنْ أَسَاءَ فَيَعَلَيْهَا Whoever does evil, أَسَيَّ So it is for against it. But وَمَا رَبُّكَ بِظَلَّامٍ لِلْعَبِيدِ And your Lord is not ever unjust to his servants. سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ نَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ نَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَنَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ